How shares are taxed in Australia. Hello everybody, welcome to Mango Monkey Learns Money. So today's video will be really quick because I know you wanna enjoy your Sunday. Anyway, in today's video, I will explain to you how shares are taxed in Australia. When you invest in shares, there are two types of income you will potentially get. The first one is called dividends. You get taxed on dividends just like you would get taxed on your salary. But if you receive a $70 dividend and the company has paid a 30% tax, your income actually gets inflated to $100. So you pay tax based on $100 worth of income. You receive what's called a franking credit, and this is unique to Australia and a small number of other countries, but not the United States. So let's say your marginal tax rate is 37%. Your tax based on a $100 worth of income is going to be $37. But because the company you invest in has already paid $30, you only pay $7 extra. The $30 is a franking credit, which you can claim on your tax return as a type of prepaid tax. So it's a bit like a tax credit. Like how if you work for someone, you will claim the tax that has been withheld by your employer. The second type of income that you will get from investing in shares, assuming you actually make money on it, is capital gain. In Australia, if you buy one share for $100 and you sell this share again for $150, you make $50 worth of capital gains. But if you have held onto this share for at least 12 months, you only get taxed on half the capital gain. So you pay tax based on $25 profit instead of $50. Effectively, your tax rate is half. In fact, for most people, it will be less than half because Australia has a marginal tax rate system, so your tax bracket probably moves downwards if your income is half. So this is really good. What also comes into play is that you are not only reducing the tax that you need to pay, you will also be able to reinvest more of your money, and you'll get that magic effect of compound interest working for you to amplify the amount of savings you make. So on the balance of probabilities, it is probably better for you to sell your shares after 12 months rather than before. Did you enjoy this video today? If so, please drop me a like, so YouTube likes me a little bit more. Have a lovely weekend and all the best for everything.